Please welcome Mayim Bialik.
Hi.
Oh my gosh. I think there is no one on earth I'd rather speak to this morning. I was listening to your podcast. We have a new program here where we're shining a spotlight on our podcasts that are the new frontier. And so we would like to put a spotlight on yours, Mayim Bialik's Breakdown. It's The Download. In your podcast, I was listening to with Glenn and Doyle, you really are willing to go there about marriage and divorce and co-parenting and therapy and eating disorders and everything in life. And I just was wondering how you have the bravery and the wherewithal to look within and yet also put it out.
Well, I mean, I really appreciate the question, especially from you, knowing that, you know, we both grew up in the public eye and also in complicated and dynamic creative families. You know, for me, growing up surrounded by mental illness, we didn't talk about it, you know? It was just like, oh, this person acts like this, or oh, you don't know what to expect if you hang out with this person, or this person, you know, behaves in a way that's hurtful. And we didn't really talk about it, but, you know, in the years since I was a child, I did. I grew up in the public eye. I went to graduate school. I got my degree in neuroscience. And a huge emphasis of my thesis and also just sort of my life post-child celebrity has been about learning about the world around me and about my place in it. And it really wasn't until this last year that my partner Jonathan Cohen and I decided to sort of like put our time and energy where our heads are. And that's in the world of mental health. You know, I've benefited from therapy. There have been times when I've been on medication. There have been times when I haven't been on medication. But we started a podcast that is all things mental health. And it's not like, here's how to fix your life. Like, I'm the celebrity who's going to tell you how to do this. It's like, I'm still figuring it out. He's still figuring it out. And we're speaking to people who are also still trying to figure it out. So in terms of the Glenn and Doyle episode, I'm a huge, huge, I mean, fan is not the right word. Like, yeah. I feel intimately connected with her, even though, you know, like I just have met her recently. But she goes there, you know, she talks so bravely about her eating disorder history, her mental health history. And it's something that I finally decided, like, if I'm not going to talk about it, why am I here, you know, touting other people who do? So it was actually not an impulsive decision, but that's kind of what the podcast does. Every episode, people are sharing things that many of them say, I've never shared this with anyone. People are talking about addiction, suicide attempts, like things that we didn't even anticipate when we just said, let's talk to people who are open about mental health. So that's kind of where we're at. Apparently, I've put it all out there. And that episode in particular, I shared a lot of things I've literally never shared before.
I was so grateful to hear it. And you just said something that rang, ugh, I'm probably gonna burst into tears because I'm so that guy and I just had one of those days. But when you're a celebrity, you don't feel like you have the right to complain.
Correct.
You just don't. You have it too good. And it's hard.
Well, I think that's...
But that's not the human experience.
Yeah, and I think that's also... Well, and I think also that's... You know, as a woman, sometimes we're not allowed to say something. Or as a mom, it's like, well, you had kids, what do you expect, right? Or, well, you got married, what did you expect? And I think, like, that's part of what I'm trying to do in not being this, like, shiny celebrity person who's like, here's how to meditate. Which, look, if people want that from celebrities, there are definitely, you know, podcasts and outlets. That's not what I'm doing. I'm doing, like, let's try this. I went to a shaman. Is chiropractic real? Like, what do we do? What's the science behind all these things? What works and what doesn't? And honestly, that comes from speaking to people who've lived it. Look, without social media, without this access to our public people, yeah, I wouldn't be having this conversation. But this is what, and this is the beautiful work that you're doing also, is using this presence to say, we're still human. My kid still thinks I'm the stupidest person in the world, and I can't freaking walk up the stairs right without him saying, what do you want? What's your problem? Why are you, you know, being mean to me? It's like, I'm literally walking up the stairs. That's stuff that happens It happens no matter what. And yes, there's absolutely differential resources. There's systemic racism, there's systemic injustice, but we're still all human. And I'm a scientist, and this is still what it's like.
And what I love is that you did study science, because since we have had this blessing with a lot of effort, work, and energy, and a board vision, and we've been able to maintain longevity, which is just, again, it's where I feel like I should never complain, because I managed to still be here, and I'm so grateful for that journey, and I want to keep it real. I want to be like, I am flawed, I am struggling, I will not stay stuck, I will figure this out, it takes longer than I want it to, I'm divorced, I'm co-parenting, I have problems, I struggle, blah, you know. But at the same time, I am an optimist, and that is my truth. But I want to figure things out. I want to look within. I don't want to point the finger outward. Was it a part of getting the science degree? Did you know not to look without, but to work within?
I mean, look, it's really been a journey. You know, I've been in therapy since I'm, 17 years old. So it's been a very long journey. But as they say in the 12-step rooms, figure it out is not a slogan. So the notion that I will be able to kind of figure it out is something that I get to kind of set aside as I just put one foot in front of the other, you know? And I have a real like one day at a time philosophy. Like, I'm gonna do today. I've never parented my kids today, right? This is the first today that there ever has been. And tomorrow's gonna be a whole new one. So what I get to do is today, I wake up with gratitude. I wake up and say, hey, I woke up. My breath was returned to me, you know? And then I go about my day one step at a time. You know, I'm super honored that I get to speak to you, because also connecting with other people who are like-minded is a thing that's missing in a culture where we're all connected, you know, like this. So
absolutely,
it's actually really nice to have this connection.
You really saved my soul this morning driving to work. My kid was on the street corner kicking me in the shins. Like, it was just, and you know, it was just a, it was, I was crying. It was just DEFCON 5. And I got in the car and I put your podcast back in, and you said just what you said. I have never been this age with children this age today before in my life. This is my first day doing it. So I will take this day as a newcomer to this moment with all the wisdom I've learned and the wisdom I will learn. And it was revelatory. I've never thought of life in that context. Thank you.
I'm your new best friend.
I know. And I also, you have brought so much joy to our lives.